Hello all, today we will be creating an application which will actually predict whether a person is basically having a heart disease or not. This particular problem statement, I found it very interesting because the data set is basically from Kaggle and the data set is awesome. If you just go and click the link provided in this Jupyter notebook, and this Jupyter notebook is actually uploaded in the GitHub, so you can download it from there and try to go to this particular heart disease UCI Kaggle link. And try to see the features. The features are awesome. You have features like age, sex, what is your chest pain, T-type, trust PPS, that is your blood pressure, your cholesterol level, everything. And they are very different kind of features present in over here. And what I have done is that I have basically applied two different kind of machine learning algorithm. One is k-nearest neighbor, and then the other one is random forest. And I have actually seen the accuracy and what all methods I have actually followed. I basically followed, converting the category features into dummy variables. I've also seen whether the data set is imbalanced or not and all those things. So as we go ahead, I'll be telling you all about this. So initially, as usual, please import all the necessary libraries that you require. NumPy and Matplotlib. If you want Seaborn also, you can basically, import it. Then today in this particular experiment, I'll be experimenting with three different algorithms. Now in this particular algorithms, what we will be discussing is that, first of all, I'll be trying to do with k nearest neighbor, then we'll go ahead with random forest classifier. Decision tree will be an assignment for you, so please try to do it. I'll definitely tell you that you'll be able to get better accuracy than random forest or k nearest neighbor. So just check whether you're able to get better accuracy or not. So I'm importing all these libraries. I've downloaded that dataset and named it as dataset.csv. Just execute this, as everybody know how to read datasets by using pandas. Then I've just seen the basic information of my features that are present in the dataset. So here I have df.info and here is all my features. This many columns I basically have. Then after that, I've also done describe. This helps you to see the mean, median, what is the 25%, 50%, 75%. This is just a part of feature engineering which will help you to give, which will give you more idea about how the features is actually distributed. Then after this, from here, I have actually come into the most feature engineering part. Now this particular feature, I would like to say it as a feature selection, because here I'm basically using correlation, okay? Feature. And this is basically done in order to find out if all the features are positively correlated or negatively correlated. Here it is, the code that basically I'm going to use is basically called a Seaborn. I've already explained a lot of feature selection techniques in my previous video. Please, if you have not seen that, go ahead and see it in the data science interview playlist about the feature selection. And I've explained you three major types through coding examples. It is very simple. So here it is. I'm just using df.correlation. This is basically the function that we are going to use. And what it will do is that it will try to find out all the features and how it is correlated with respect to the target output. Now over here, my target output is something like this. Now you can see this chest pain has a positive correlation with respect to the target output 0.43. So it is obvious if you have a chest pain, that is a symptom of having heart disease. Similarly, you will be having different features. Cholesterol will also be one of the feature. But now you can see that there are some features that are also having negative correlation. Okay, negative correlation. So make sure to select those features that are having positive correlations and try to use those features. You can also use negative correlation, because the value, if the value decreases of that particular negative correlation, that basically means the heart disease prediction may be quite high and the person suffering from their heart disease will be more. Okay, so just make sure that you see this correlation and try to see each and every attribute. And this is just a small histogram to see each and every features, how it is distributed. And most of the time you can see this is distributed in a standard normal distribution. The main part is basically to understand, we need to find out whether the data set is balanced or not. Okay, it is always a good practice to find out whether the data set is balanced or not. So in order to set it out, I'm taking the target variable and just giving the data as and some styling mechanism. And always remember, my target output is basically whether the person is having the heart disease or is not having the heart disease. So that particular value is 0 or 1. And that thing is basically given in this particular data set itself. If you really want to see, now here it is. This is the target output. It will be either 1 or 0. So you can basically check out from here. Okay. So that's it. Then what you can do is that you can basically plot a counter plot and try to find out what is the count. Now here you can see that zero is basically the person is not having heart disease. The count is somewhere around 130. Oh, sorry, it is somewhere around 140. And the other count of the person of not having or person having that heart disease is basically more than 160. So this looks like a quite a balanced data set, you know. 140 to 160 is perfectly fine. It is somewhere near around 50-50 or 60-40. It's fine. So we can basically consider this as a balanced data set. So let us move ahead with the data pre-processing. Now in this, what I had observed is that there are some features like sex, CP, which is my chest pain type, FBS. All these features are basically, you know, they are categorical features. Okay. Now I have to take these features and try to convert this into a dummy variables. Okay. And I have already discussed in many of my videos how to convert that into dummy variables. So I'll not go in more deep into it, but just see by seeing the data sets, you'll understand which all features are having the category features, and you can convert that into a dummy variable. So in order to convert it, you basically use pd.getDummies, get underscore dummies. This will automatically do it for you. Now, after this, I'm also doing some standard scaling. The reason I'm doing standard scaling because there are some features, you know, they are basically having a lot of variations and they are also measured in different units. Whenever this kind of variables are basically measured in different units, you should prefer doing standard scaling. That will help you to, you know, rescale or scale down your value within the same distribution. What the standard normal distribution, based on the standard normal distribution, that is, it may be between -3 to +3 or -1 to +1 or -2 to +2. That depends on completely on the distribution, how your data is basically done. Okay. So in order to do that, import standard scaler, apply standard scaler, column to scales, you know what are columns to scales, and you just do fit transform on this particular column to scale data set. Okay. And you're not doing on every categories because these all are category features, right? So you don't have to do on this. You have to do on the remaining categories. That is what is preferred. And don't do it for the target output because it is already 0 and 1. You don't have to do to that. Okay. Now after this, you can see I've just checked the head part. You can see all these features are basically my dummy variables that has got created from all the category features. Okay. And remaining all, you can see over here, they have been rescaled down based on the standard normal distribution. Okay. Then I create my dependent feature, simple. Then what I do is that I also import cross-val score. Cross-val score is basically for applying cross-validation, so I'm using it. KNN, everybody knows about KNN, I guess, because I've already uploaded a video. Guys, if you have not seen that, please go over there. I've also implemented a project on KNN. Clearly, it is very easily explained with all the diagrams and all the theoretical information. So for KNN, it is basically a k-nearest neighbor. I'm basically trying for 20k nearest neighbor for each and every nearest neighbor. Suppose for the first iteration, my k value will be 1. For one neighbor, what will be my cross-val score accuracy mean? So this cross-val score helps me to get the cross-validation score. And finally, I'm doing the score.mean. Okay. Now, based on this 10 experiments, right, I'll be having 10 different values of score. So I'm doing score.mean. Right. So for every iteration from 1 to 21, that is one nearest neighbor till the 21st nearest neighbor, I'm actually finding out the score, which is just like my accuracy. And then after that, I'm plotting it. And this particular plotted value basically specifies that for k is equal to 1, what was the accuracy? Now you can just open the image in the next tab. And if I go down, now you can see over here for k is equal to 1, my accuracy was 74%. For k is equal to 2, my accuracy was 76%. Then for k is equal to 3, it was 81. 4 is 80. 5, 83, 83, 87. So you can see one of the scenario where my K value is actually 12, it is 85%, right? So what I'll do is that in the next step, I can prefer using the K value as found out from here 12. So what I can do is that I can just copy the same code and consider making my model with K value is equal to 12. So I'll just copy this, go down. Okay, make a cell above because my k value is now considered as 12. Let me just go and see the score, what it is. So here it is, I've got executed. Now, after this, I can just display my KNN underscore scores. Here it is. If I do dot mean, there's a list of accuracy over here. Is a list of accuracy, and I've already appended the cross validation score of 10 different iterations, you know. Okay, sorry, I did not have to use this KNN. Instead, I can just use scores.me. As KNN was a previous list that I had actually created for different. It is giving me some error. Oh, it is score. Now you can see that my accuracy is around 85% after applying cross validation. When my n underscore neighbor is 12, okay? Make sure you use this. Now, similarly, what you can do is for random forest class, if you import it, take the decision trees as 10, apply cross-val score. Here you can see that you're getting a mean of 81%. This you can see that, again, I've not applied what all parameters I should select inside this by using grid search CV or randomized search CV. But default parameters, and just by selecting the k value as 12, I'm getting a better accuracy than this. Then I would prefer using KNN instead of random forest classifier. Another assignment for you will be that please go and try to use decision tree and try to see whether you're getting a better accuracy than this. This was all about the videos, guys. I hope you like this particular video. Please do subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed. I'll see you all in the next video. Have a great day ahead. Have a wonderful learning process, and never give up. Keep on trying. I'll see you all in the next video. Thank you all. God bless you.